they were not on the same level as the Levites. This teaches us that every leader and every group needs to be taken seriously. Hmm. I don't care what role you have, people are always going to resent you because of envy and jealousy. They feel that success should be theirs and that all honor and glory should go to them. All
right.
Envy, lust, and the pursuit of honor can drive the person out of the world. The fact that these are destructive emotions does not stop some people, perhaps most of us, feeling from time to time, and nothing does more to put us at risk, put risk to the harmony of the group. That is one reason why a leader must be humble. He or she should feel none of these things. But a leader must also be aware that not everyone is humble. Every Moses has been Korah. There's no way of eliminating danger entirely. But Moses in this week's parsha tells us how to behave. Honor everyone equally. Pay special attention to potentially disaffected groups. Make each feel valued. Give everyone a moment in life and a limelight, if only in a ceremonial way. Set a personal example of humility. Make it clear to all that leadership is a service, not a form of status. Find ways which those with a particular passion can express it, and ensure that everyone has a chance to contribute. This is something that can be taught. It goes back to taking care of our tabernacle and putting in the wisdom, the knowledge, and the understanding that will help us to humble ourselves and to learn to treat each other equally.
Come on.